cruise missiles represent true marvels of modern engineering, blending advanced guidance systems, powerful propulsion, and remarkable range capabilities. It's astonishing to think that these sophisticated weapons evolved from humble beginnings. The first missile was little more than an elaborate firework, developed in China over 800 years ago. Fast forward to World War II, and the V-1 flying bomb marked a pivotal moment in the history of cruise missiles. Though lacking the precision of today's versions, the V-1 showcased the terrifying potential of an autonomous weapon capable of reaching distant targets. From those early rudimentary concepts to the precision-guided, highly effective missiles of today, the evolution of cruise missile technology has been nothing short of extraordinary. The journey from crude prototypes to sophisticated, state-of-the-art systems is a testament to how far we've come in military innovation. A cruise missile is an unmanned, self-propelled, guided vehicle that maintains flight through aerodynamic lift throughout its journey. Its primary mission is to deliver a payload, such as a high-explosive warhead, to a specific target with pinpoint accuracy. They can be launched from various platforms, including ground vehicles, aircraft, surface ships, and submarines, providing military forces with extensive deployment options. Cruise missiles can be broadly classified into two categories: subsonic and supersonic cruise missiles. Subsonic cruise missiles, like the US Tomahawk or the Russian Kalibr, travel at speeds below the speed of sound, Mach 1, while supersonic cruise missiles, such as the Russian P-800 Onyx or the Indian Brahmos, travel at speeds exceeding the speed of sound, Mach 1 and above. Propulsion systems are vital components of cruise missiles. Cruise missiles are typically powered by two distinct propulsion systems: the launch system, or rocket booster, and a cruise engine. The launch system is used for the initial boost phase, providing sufficient speed and altitude for the missile to transition to the cruise phase. Once the missile reaches the desired altitude and speed, the rocket booster is jettisoned and the cruise engine takes over. The cruise engine is usually a small, fuel-efficient jet engine, such as a turbojet or turbofan. The choice of engine depends on the required speed, range, and altitude for the specific missile. Turbojet engines are more suitable for supersonic cruise missiles, as they provide higher speeds. In contrast, turbofan engines are preferred for subsonic cruise missiles due to their fuel efficiency and lower noise emissions, which can help reduce the missile's detectability. Cruise missiles use flight control systems to maintain stability and control during flight. These systems typically consist of aerodynamic control surfaces, such as wings, tail fins, and canards, which are adjusted by onboard actuators in response to guidance system commands. The flight control system also ensures that the missile can perform evasive maneuvers if necessary to avoid enemy defenses. Some missiles fly close to the Earth's surface, skimming just meters above the ground to evade radar systems, while others maintain higher altitudes for greater fuel efficiency or to avoid missile defense systems. They may also be equipped with electronic countermeasure or ECM systems that jam or deceive enemy radar and tracking systems. Guidance systems are crucial for ensuring the accuracy and reliability of these weapons. Early guidance methods, such as inertial guidance, are still in use today and allow the missile to follow a flight path programmed before launch. But, of course, there have been a lot of advances in this field. One of those advances is terrain contour matching, or TERCOM, which compares a terrain map to the missile's current position to ensure it remains on the correct path. Global positioning system, or GPS guidance, has also become a standard feature in many modern cruise missiles, providing a connection to GPS or GLONASS satellite systems for highly accurate targeting. In the terminal phase of flight, cruise missiles employ various guidance methods to increase accuracy and ensure the missile strikes its intended target. These include laser-guided systems, TV guidance, radar seekers, infrared or IR guidance, and digital scene matching area correlation or DSMAC. Examples of modern cruise missiles include the US Tomahawk Land Attack Missile, or TLAM, which has been widely used in conflicts such as the Gulf War, the Iraq War, and the intervention in Libya. The US cruise missile inventory also includes the AGM-86B and AGM-129 Maverick missiles. In addition to the examples mentioned above, other cruise missiles, such as the British Storm Shadow or SCALPEG in France and German-Swedish missile KEPD 350 Taurus, have significant innovations. The Storm Shadow, a joint British-French innovation, is a long-range stealth cruise missile designed for precise strikes on high-value targets, such as enemy infrastructure and military bases. The Storm Shadow cruise missile has a weight of approximately 2,900 pounds and is equipped with a conventional warhead that weighs 990 pounds. Its maximum body diameter measures 19 inches and it boasts a wingspan of 120 inches. The missile's propulsion is achieved through a microturbo TRI 6030 turbojet engine, propelling it at speeds of Mach 0.8. This formidable piece of weaponry has an impressive range of about 350 miles. It is armed with a powerful brooch warhead designed to breach fortified structures before exploding, thus inflicting substantial damage. The Taurus KEPD 350, standing for Target Adaptive Unitary and Dispenser Robotic Ubiquity System, is a long-range cruise missile engineered to precisely target fortified positions without requiring the launching aircraft to penetrate hostile air defense territories. The Taurus missile is the brainchild of Taurus Systems GmbH, a collaborative venture between MBDA Deutschland and Sweden's Saab Bosfors Dynamics AB. Initiated in 1998, the missile's development progressed rapidly, culminating in flight tests by 2004 and subsequent service adoption. The missile's physical structure stretches 16.7 feet in length, with a diameter that measures 3.5 feet. The weight, crucial for its aerial launch, comes in at around 3,086 pounds. Its structural design prioritizes stealth. The rectangular body, crafted from composite materials, avoids sharp interfaces, making it less perceptible to radars. Furthermore, a special radio-absorbent coating masks its presence even more. Ingeniously, the air intake channels are curved, a feature devised to hide the engine turbine from prying ground radars. The missile harnesses the power of an American Textron P8-315 turbofan engine. Thanks to this powerhouse, the Taurus maintains a steady subsonic speed in the vicinity of Mach 0.6 to 0.95. The missile's reach is nothing short of impressive, capable of engaging targets up to 310 miles away. Once launched, the Taurus employs its Tri-Tech navigation system, merging various sensors and reference databases to consistently monitor its position and adjust its trajectory. Relying on a mix of TRN, or Terrain Reference Navigation, and IBN, Image-Based Navigation, autonomous systems, it harnesses inertial navigation, which gets periodic in-flight refinements. As the missile approaches its destination, a thermal imaging head springs to life, sharpening its strike precision in the missile's terminal phase. Central to its arsenal is a two-way data line. This modern feature allows the missile to tackle moving targets and be dynamically redirected in flight, an advantage in ever-evolving combat scenarios. The Taurus missile's tandem warhead, designed for maximum penetration and high sophistication in target optimization, or Mephisto, is tailored to decimate hard and deep-set targets. The primary charge of this combat unit is 1.2 feet wide and 1.7 feet long. Designed to pierce through barriers, its explosive payload weighs in at 881 pounds and is housed within a 7.2-foot durable casing. The Mephisto warhead features the cutting-edge PIMF blasting system, imbued with artificial intelligence courtesy of Smart Head Target Attack Fusing technology. This AI-enhanced system utilizes an accelerometer to gauge shock intensities at the collision point, cross-checking with stored benchmarks to determine the perfect moment for detonation. Just before striking, the missile discharges a precursor-shaped charge weighing 220 pounds, creating an opening in a fortified structure or subterranean bunker. This paves the way for the more substantial penetrator to enter seamlessly. When placed side by side with the Storm Shadow missile, the Taurus exhibits distinct advantages. The first notable superiority emerges in the missile's range, which spans 310 miles. This ensures that the aircraft launching the Taurus can stay clear of enemy defenses, reducing risks to both the pilot and the aircraft. Also, the meticulously designed Mephisto tandem warhead is adept at handling targets that are fortified or placed underground, granting the Taurus a crucial advantage in certain mission profiles. As we have seen, cruise missiles have come a long way from their humble beginnings. Their journey has been one of incredible innovation and technological advancement, driven by the need for ever more powerful and precise weapons in modern warfare. And yet, their story is far from over. The advent of hypersonic technology and the rapid development of artificial intelligence are set to open new horizons for these deadly yet fascinating machines. Meanwhile, the use of advanced AI algorithms and machine learning will enable cruise missiles to adapt to ever more complex scenarios, improving their accuracy and reducing the risk of collateral damage. This concludes our episode that provides a glimpse into the cruise missiles. So what do you think about these remarkable weapon systems? What other pieces of military hardware would you like us to cover in our future episodes? Also, if you were lucky enough to see these weapons up close, or better yet, operated one, please comment. Remember to hit the subscribe button and ring that bell to stay updated with our latest content. And while you're here, why not check out another one of our exciting videos? Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.